Greetings to all on World Parkinson's Day. I'm Dr. Parul Dubey from Manipal Hospitals, Goa, working as a consultant neurologist. Parkinsonism is a neurological disorder which involves various motor aspects of the body in the form of gait disturbances, tremors, postural imbalances, and also a multitude of other issues are associated with it, like bladder and bowel disturbances, autonomic dysfunction, speech and swallowing disturbances, etc. It's important to remember that this illness has a psychological and social burden on the individual, the family, and the caregivers, which needs to be addressed because it has a bearing on the overall management of Parkinsonism. I would like to emphasize here that preventing falls is a very important part of managing Parkinsonism as a whole, especially in the elderly, because preventing falls can itself lead to a prevention of so many untoward complications that arise out of it. When Parkinsonism afflicts a person gets trapped in a body which has physical incapacity. While earlier those physical faculties were at the beck and call of a person, now he finds himself unable to do simple things and becomes dependent. While the inner being and the inner personality of the person quite often remains very intact, alert, and active. Understanding this point is very important as a physician and as a caregiver. Our care and compassion goes a long way in making the lives of these people who are suffering and struggling with their physical incapacity. It adds value and meaning to their life. They deserve a dignified treatment. We should make all efforts to provide them a congenial atmosphere which adds to the progress of the person as a whole. We have to treat the person in a holistic way so that his psychological and spiritual growth keeps on happening while we also work on the physical aspects associated with the illness. Lastly, today, in the time of COVID, especially, I would like to make a prayer saying these lines from the Upanishads. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah. Meaning thereby, that may all be happy, truly happy, and may all be free of disease. So my prayer and my wish on this day is that may our world and our earth be disease free. May all illnesses disappear from this earth. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Safal Shetty. I'm a consultant neurologist working in Manipal Hospital, Goa. I wish everyone happy Parkinson's Day, which is celebrated on April 11th this year. Parkinson's disease is a disease which commonly affects the elderly population, usually more than 60 years of age. However, there are patients who come before that also, that is less than 60 years of age as well. So in them, we have to think about a genetic basis for Parkinson's disease. So what constitutes Parkinson's disease basically? It's a disease which affects the mobility of a person. So they will predominantly come with tremors on one side of the body. So the tremors which are there are present only while they are in a sitting position or while they are in rest. It doesn't happen when the person is trying to do any activities. Along with the tremors, they also have slowness, which means that the pace with which they walk, the pace with which they speak reduces. So these are the two important points which we have to remember whenever we think about Parkinson's disease. So when do we get medical attention for this kind for this particular disease? Is that whenever an elderly person has tremors on one side of the body, predominantly at rest, and also whenever there is slowness of his activities of daily living. These are the two points, these are the two features which we have to keep in mind whenever we are thinking about Parkinson's disease. So once the person gets medical attention, how do we go about it from there? Usually, brain imaging in the form of MRI is done to rule out any other cause of Parkinson's disease. Like Parkinson's disease can mimic stroke also, so usually a neuroimaging in the form of MRI is done. So once the diagnosis of Parkinson's disease is made, the treatment is available in the form of medications mainly. And another important point is that what is the basis for Parkinson's disease? Basically what happens is that there is decrease in a chemical in the brain called dopamine. Dopamine is a chemical which is required for us to move around at the regular pace. Whenever there is decrease in this chemical dopamine, the pace of the person walking and all these tremors come out. So in treatment of Parkinson's disease, what is done is that the dopamine is given from outside as a tablet. That's what is the main treatment for Parkinson's disease. So once the dopamine is started in the form of a medication, it has to be taken for lifelong. And we know that Parkinson's disease is a disease which progresses gradually in the form that the tremors can become more, even the slowness of the activities will become slightly more even with the medications. But there are medications so that the disease is stabilized and the progression is also slowed down. So whenever the disease becomes slightly advanced, then there is an option of surgery for these patients in the form of deep brain stimulation. So feasibility for deep brain stimulation has to be checked before making a person undergo deep brain stimulation. As such, the life expectancy of the Parkinson's patients does not decrease. They can have other comorbidities in the form of diabetes or hypertension, which can have an impact on their life expectancy. All in all, Parkinson's disease is a disease which is going to affect the person's mobility mainly, and it has a significant impact on the caregiver also. Because as the disease progresses, the caregiver has to be there all the time with the patient. So it can cause certain amount of psychological impact on the caregiver as well. There are new medications which are being available in the market nowadays, and also research is underway for new medications and also new techniques so that the Parkinson's disease treatment can be made better. I wish everyone happy Parkinson's Day. Thank you so much.